previously announced Dr. E.J. Helms, superintendent of Morgan Memorial, for the past 41 years. This morning we'll help to celebrate the 111th anniversary of Henry Morgan's birth by being interviewed as to his opinion of the future of Morgan Memorial work. It may be well to remind the radio audience that Morgan Memorial is keeping open house today, and all our listeners are cordially invited to visit this enterprise and inspect its many departments. Reverend Samuel Coles is interviewing Dr. Helms, and the next voice you will hear is that of Mr. Coles.
Dr. Helms, I've come to get your forecast of the future of Morgan Memorial. But before you make a statement as to that, I wish you would answer three or four questions that may clear our minds as to what Morgan Memorial now is. First, will you please tell me how the Morgan Memorial business differs from an ordinary business enterprise?
I will be glad to answer your questions as far as I am able, Mr. Coles. Morgan Memorial's business deals in broken down materials, more difficult to restore than to make new articles. It employs broken down workers, some old, slow, clumsy folk, unable to find situations in normal industry. It sells in a broken down market. Its customers, for the most part, buy in Goodwill stores because they cannot pay the prices prevailing in other stores. It exists for service and not for profit. Unlike ordinary business, it gives primary attention to the human. It takes the inefficient who are discarded by business and not wanted by the church. Our Goodwill industries give work to the poor in an atmosphere of goodwill and after a careful study of their needs.
Do I understand that Morgan Memorial is not a stock company and pay no profits?
That is right. We have never paid any dividends or made any profits. All we receive after small overhead charges is paid to the unfortunate in wages.
How does the Morgan Memorial differ from other social service enterprises?
Our Goodwill industries endorse most of the teaching and practice of scientific charity. It investigates and studies causes, but generally it regards a job above an investigation, not charity, but a chance. It believes more in prevention than cure. That is what a job does. It prevents. Moreover, a job with its wages usually multiplies the amount of the cash to the needy who work. Work greatly enhances the morale of those who help themselves and others by their labor in our industry. This work is carried on in an atmosphere of goodwill and religious culture.
How does Morgan Memorial differ from other churches or religious organizations?
Morgan Memorial is a religious organization plus. Goodwill industries without the spirit of goodwill permeating stores, offices, and workshops is pagan. Goodwill industries seek to be Christian. Its minister is chiefly to the underprivileged and undesired. Its chapel service is regarded as essential both for the responsible and opportunity workers. Staff conferences, fellowship meetings, and church gatherings are permeated with prayer in order to ascertain the mind of the master and secure his cooperation. These meetings are unsectarian. Morgan does not proselyte.
I hear that Morgan Memorial is a very democratic institution. Will you please tell me in what respects?
Morgan Memorial is democratically organized. Employees have representatives on the board of directors. Our staff meetings of workers determine our internal management. Our wages are usually fixed on quality and quantity of product, on personality expressed in team play, on cooperation in spiritual and social endeavors.
Thank you, Dr. Helms, for these answers. I think now I may better understand your answer to the main question I am requested to ask you. That is,
to be, what is to be the future of your enterprise?
Morgan Memorial's future depends upon its fidelity in carrying out the principles expressed in my replies to your previous questions. First, if Morgan Memorial can help even a little to get business to make service rather than profit its supreme objective, it will help to solve one of the biggest problems in the world today. Morgan Memorial pays no profit. After a small overhead and a small expense of supervision, all is paid in wages to the underprivileged. Second, we believe that our government and social service organizations are nearly all ready to renounce the deteriorating dole and insist on giving self-respecting jobs. Morgan Memorial believes in treating the unfortunate as human beings rather than cases. Morgan Memorial has much yet to do in counteracting sentimental slobbering and scientific heartlessness. We believe our unsectarian, non-proselyting ways of our church are the right ones, and that humanity must have God to lift it out of selfishness into its highest possibilities. That requires a long, cooperative effort. Fourth, the world has not been made safe for democracy. It will never be until business, social, and religious leaders insist that freedom shall be dominant in our dealings with men. If our principles are right, we can trust God to lead us into the new day. If Morgan Memorial can lift the undermost, then all above us will be lifted also. And let us not forget that Morgan Memorial Enterprises are now in 98 cities in America and 17 in foreign lands, and we have contacts with about 5 million people. We've got a good start. There is much paganism at home and abroad to conquer. We have courage and are unafraid. With the prayerful cooperation of millions of our bank contributors and of our workers and the help of Almighty God, we will press on till the curse of poverty and exploitation is banished from mankind.
Thank you, Dr. Helms. You have given us something to think about. To accomplish what you're after, I think Morgan Memorial will be needed for some time to come.
Not only that, time, Mr. Coles, but also loyalty to our ideals. Morgan Memorial is preeminently spiritual. There is no future for Morgan Memorial apart from its ideals.